He's dangerous, but not crazy. It's all part of the plan. Kim Jong-un's nuclear weapons are insurance policy against being ousted by a U.S.-led invasion like Saddam Hussein, experts claim. Kim Jong-un's cartoonish image should not fool the international community into thinking he is not clever and rational, North Korea experts warn. They claim Kim's obsession with building nuclear missiles that can reach the U.S. is not an indication that he is looking to start a war, but to prevent one. The North Korean dictator, whose most recent nuclear missile test is claimed to have proven that his warheads can soon reach U.S. shores, was branded a chubby-faced maniac playing with dangerous toys by Filipino President Rodrigo Duterte yesterday. However, experts say this could not be further from the truth, explaining that the North Korean nuclear missile program is Kim's insurance policy against being ousted from power like Iraqi dictator Saddam Hussein. The late Iraqi dictator was deposed by U.S.-led international coalition forces following an invasion dubbed Operation Iraqi Freedom in 2003 that preceded the Iraq War. Kim Jong-un is allegedly hoping that by developing nuclear weapons that can threaten the U.S., he can prevent himself suffering the same fate. North Korea last week conducted its second intercontinental ballistic missile test, which led Kim to boast he could strike any target in the United States. A nuclear weapons program is the most powerful bargaining chip that North Korea has, Ju Sung-ha, a North Korean defector told USA Today. Jenny Town, assistant director of the U.S. Korea Institute at Johns Hopkins School of Advanced International Studies, also disputed the view that the nuclear program is simply caused by Kim's obsession with weapons and power. The idea that Kim Jong-un's decisions, particularly about his nuclear weapons program, are irrational is a myth, Ms. Town told the news website. The caricature, cartoonish image of him is easy for people to believe. This came after speech by Philippines President Rodrigo Duterte on Wednesday in which he warned that Kim could destroy Asia by triggering a nuclear war, branding him a son of a W maniac. Duterte said the tyrant is playing with dangerous toys and that people should not be fooled by that chubby face that looks nice. The Philippines leader teed off against crazy man Kim ahead of a regional security meeting in his capital Manila this weekend, where the hermit state's ballistic missile tests will be a hot agenda item. North Korea is set to face a diplomatic barrage over its nuclear weapons program, with the United States seeking to build a chorus of condemnation. Foreign ministers from all the major powers involved in trying to curtail North Korean leader Kim Jong-un's atomic ambitions will be in the Philippine capital for the event, offering a rare chance for face-to-face talks on the crisis. The United States and China have been wrestling with how best to respond to North Korea's second intercontinental ballistic missile test last week, which deepened global fears over Kim's nuclear weapons strike capabilities. U.S. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson will seek to build diplomatic pressure on the North in Manila, with Washington pushing for another round of tough United Nations sanctions on Pyongyang, according to one of his top aides. What we would expect to see this year at the meeting would be a general chorus of condemnation of North Korea's provocative behavior, Susan Thornton, the acting U.S. Assistant Secretary of State, told reporters in Washington. The annual forum, hosted by the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, ASEAN, brings together the top diplomats from 26 countries and the European Union for talks on political and security issues in Asia-Pacific.